Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Magandang gabi sa Panginoon at magandang gabi sa bawat isa. Ating pong ialay ang pag-aaral natin sa gabing ito. Tayo po'y manalangin. Magandang gabi po sa iyo, dakilang Diyos, aming mapagmahal na Ama, sa pangalan mo po na aming Panginoong Jesucristo. Salamat, Lord, sa iyong masaganang biyaya, pag-ibig para sa bawat isa sa amin. Patuloy na inalay namin, Panginoon, ang pag-aaral namin sa gabing ito sa inyo pong Wednesday Bible Study, aming Panginoon. At inanyayahan namin ang iyong banal na spirito na kami ay patuloy na turuan, Panginoon. At maunawaan namin ang lesson sa gabing ito, aming buhay na Diyos. Salamat po sa iyo, banal na spirito. At patuloy na sinasaway namin anumang mga gawa o panggugulo ng kaaway sa pangalan ng aming Panginoong Jesucristo. Salamat po, Ama, sa iyong biyaya, sa iyong kabutihan sa amin, sa pangalan mo po na aming Panginoong Jesucristo. Amen. Yan. Hallelujah. Praise God. So, patuloy po tayo sa ating lesson, Biblical Worldview. Yan. So, it's third week ng ating lesson, and we shall have a short review. So, biblical worldview is a set of beliefs, assumptions, or values based on the Bible that determines how a person lives. Yan. So, paano tayo mamumuhay sa sanlibutan ito? There must be a guiding principle, no? Kumbaga sa appliance, meron kang user's manual o yung manufacturer's manual, no? Sa atin po, sa buhay natin, kailangan natin yung creator's manual. So, para alam natin how we should live our lives. So, it's a set of beliefs, mga bagay na kailangan nating mga paniwalaan patungkol sa salita ng Diyos. So, the goal of worldview training is to shape beliefs with the Bible to equip a young person to apply God's truth to life for the good of others and the glory of God. So, yung kailangan gawin, alamin natin kung ano ba ang kalooban ng Diyos at yun po ay ating sundin. No? So, to apply God's truth in our lives. Yan. So, last time din, meron na-review natin, yung worldview, culture, and personal perspectives, yung relationship nila sa isa't isa. So, makita natin na gusto natin yung ating mga personal beliefs or views ay in agreement with the biblical worldview. No? So, ano ba yung sinasabi ng Panginoon sa kanyang, sa kanyang salita? Nais po natin na ganun yung ating maging pananaw. No? Kung ano ba yung view of God, gusto rin natin na yung ating biblical perspective, no? Maging ganon. So, gusto natin yung personal perspective natin in line with the biblical worldview. So, some elements of a worldview. So, last time we discussed about the origin, meaning, and purpose of life, ethics, morality, and destiny. So, kumuha lang po ako ng apat. So, origin or nature of reality. So, yung first element ng ating worldview is about ultimate reality or being. So, saan ba nagsimula ang sanlibutan ito? Where did the universe begin? Yan. So, is the universe eternal or is this universe created? So, if the universe is created, there must be a creator. So, yung ultimate reality, yung pinagsimula ng lahat ng ito ay ang Diyos. The God who is infinite and personal is our creator. He is sovereign and good. And then, yung isang item natin na external reality, no? So, aside from God, so nakita natin yung material universe. God created the universe ex nihilo. Yan. So, for the Christian, ultimate reality contains both material and spiritual elements. So, itong universe na create ng Panginoon, it has a physical, material part, and there are also spiritual elements or a spiritual part. Katulad na lang ng tao, no? We have a physical body, but we also have a spiritual body. Ayan. So, yung physical universe is real. It is not an illusion. So, bakit nasabi to? Kasi sa ibang faith system, sa ibang religion, the physical universe is an illusion. Ayan. And that all men are spiritual beings. So, yun po yung belief sa ibang religion. So, next. So, Creator and His creation. So, in the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So, He was in the beginning with God, all things were made through Him, without Him was not anything made that was made. So, yung part na to ng John speaks of our Lord Jesus Christ. It speaks of our Creator, that He was in the beginning with God, and all things were made through Him. And the second set of verses, for by Him all things were created, in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or authorities, all things were created through Him and for Him. Yan. So, itong verse na to speaks of a creation. A creation of heaven and earth. A creation of visible and invisible. So, whether thrones or dominions or rulers, all things were created through Him and for Him. So, He is before all things, and in Him all things hold together. So, by His divine power and His wisdom, God continues to sustain this universe. So, we go to the next element, the meaning and purpose of life. So, yung question sa philosophy, what is the meaning of life? And what is the end or purpose for which God created the world and the humans who inhabit it? So, it is important to recognize that God did not create humans to satisfy anything that was lacking in Him. Yan. So, ang Panginoon, there is nothing that is lacking in Him, no? He is complete in Himself. Yan. So, He did not create man because He needed something from man. No? Hindi niya tayo create kasi meron siyang kailangan sa atin. So, the God who made the world and everything in it, being Lord of heaven and earth, does not live in temples made by man. Hindi kailangan ng Diyos na ang tao ay gagawa ng templo para sa Kanya, no? Kasi hindi naman siya doon nakatira. Nor is He served by human hands. So, hindi rin siya pinaglilingkuran ng kamay ng tao as though He needed anything, no? Na hindi siya nagre-request kasi kailangan niya ang isang bagay. But He Himself gives to all mankind life and breath and everything. So, create ng Diyos ang sanlibutang ito at binigyan niya ang tao ng buhay at ng lahat ng kailangan ng tao sa sanlibutang ito, God has provided. Okay. So, humans are not the product of chance or an impersonal Big Bang, nor are we merely a blind collocation of particles in motion. So, hindi... Yung belief kasi sa science is that we are a product of chance or an impersonal Big Bang. Yan. So, yung belief nila is that man evolved. Nag-evolve tayo from simpler life forms. And these simpler life forms was created by chance. So, a random process created man. Yun ang belief nung evolutionist, no? So, it's first they believe that the universe was eternal. Na yung universe nag-exist eternally. But later on, the scientists found out that the universe had a beginning, o yung tawag nila singularity. So to explain this beginning, so they explained it with an impersonal Big Bang. No? So impersonal, meaning to say that it is not a person, it is not a being who created this world, but some chance or some random process created this world. So there's an impersonal Big Bang. Yan. O yung tao ay particles in motion. So yung ating makeup, no, yung ating nature is that we are made up of atoms and molecules, no, na nag-evolve to become human, na nag-evolve para magkaroon ng reasoning, human thought and imagination. Yan. So yun yung belief ng mga evolutionists or atheist philosophers and scientists. Pero sabi sa Bible, we are endowed with godlike properties that make us unique in creation. So sa Genesis chapter 1 verse 26, God created us in His own image. So we are divine image bearers. So we are rational, no? So meron tayong logic, meron tayong reasoning, meron tayong thought, meron tayong imagination. We are also emotional, no? Meron tayong mga feelings. And volitional. So we make decisions and we act on those decisions. So we are divine image bearers. We are created in the image of God. So here's the verse on 1:26 of Genesis. Let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and the birds of the heavens, livestock, over all the earth. So merong duty, merong responsibility na pinagkaloob ang Panginoon, yung dominion, responsibility of managing the planet. So by cooperating with God in His creation plan, we fulfill the purpose for which He created us and find satisfaction and meaning in life. Ayan. So mahalaga yung owner's manual o yung creator's manual, kasi doon natin makikita, doon natin malalaman kung ano ang kalooban ng Diyos para sa buhay natin. So we cooperate by knowing the gifts God has given us, no? Yung ating mga talents, yung ating mga spiritual gifts na pinagkaloob ng Panginoon. And we use them in such a way that God receives the praise to glorify God. Yan. So way back in 1646 and 1647, a group of theologians made this document, the Westminster Catechism. So it's a document to help new Christians understand the Christian life. So the first question they put is that, what is the chief end of man? So what is the purpose of man? So man's chief end is to glorify God and to enjoy Him forever. So we were created to worship God, to give praise to God, to give glory to God in everything we do. And we were created to enjoy His presence. Just like Adam and Eve before the fall, no, they have this fellowship, intimate fellowship with God. So what rule had God given us to direct us how we may glorify and enjoy Him? So paano natin malalaman yung mga nararapat natin gawin para ating sambahin, mapapurihan ang Diyos, at ma-enjoy natin yung fellowship ng Panginoon? So sabi, the word of God, no, yung salita ng Diyos contained in the scriptures is the only rule to direct us how we may glorify and enjoy Him. So nandun sa scripture, Old and New Testament, no, yung creator's manual, how we can enjoy God, how we can glorify God. Yan. It is contained in the Old and the New Testaments. And what do the scriptures principally teach? The scriptures principally teach what man is to believe concerning God and what duty God requires of man. Yan. So, ano ba yung Diyos? No? Ano ba yung mga dapat nating paniwalaan patungkol sa Diyos? No? Hindi na natin kailangan pa mag-invent ng Diyos, no? As the pagans do. Kasi yung pagans, they do not have the revelation of God. So, they tried to create God in their thoughts, no? They tried to create God in their own image. Yan. So, ang tao nag-invento ng kanya-kanyang Diyos. So, they worship the creation and not the creator. So, iba-iba yung itsura ng Diyos ng iba-ibang relihiyon, no, ng mga pagans. So, what man is to believe concerning God and what duty God requires of man? So, ano ba yung obligation natin? Ano ba yung duty natin? Ano ba yung mga nararapat nating gawin na nais ng Diyos na gawin natin? No? So, the fate of an atheist philosopher. So, sa book ni William Lane Craig, sabi ng isang atheist philosopher, the most rational position to hold is that the universe came from nothing, by nothing, and for nothing. Ayan. So, how do you explain the Big Bang? No? How do you explain the creation of the universe? So, yung position ng mga atheist philosopher, it came from nothing. So, kung ano, makapanood kayo ng debate about between an atheist and a Christian philosopher or scientist, so you would hear that the universe came from nothing. Yan. But what is nothing? Because this nothing created something. No? So it becomes funny, di ba? So how did nothing create something? And can nothing create something? Pwede ba yon? Yung nothing would create something. No? So paano niya na-create yon? By nothing. So ano patutunguhan nun? Anong purpose nun? For nothing. Oh, yun. Okay. So, yan yung magiging result ng thinking without the creator's manual, no? Pag ni-reject mo yung revelation ng Panginoon, you come up with different ideas about the universe. So, Romans 1:19 to 21 speaks about what can be known about God. Explain to them. It is plain to us. It is plain to man. No? So, malinaw na maunawaan ng tao what it is about God. Bakit? Because God has shown it to them. So, pinakita ng Diyos yung kanyang invisible attribute. Namely, His eternal power and divine nature. No? So, makita natin sa universe, there is such a an order in the universe. Hindi siya chaotic, no? Hindi magulo yung universe, may order, no? So, yung movement ng planets, meron siyang order, no? Yung mga laws of motion, yung gravity, no? Yung mga equations sa physics, we can do science because there is order in the universe. And not only is there order in the universe, makita rin natin yung beauty, no? Yung beauty in the universe, no? Yung the beauty of the stars, the planets, and nature, yan. So, hindi lamang order, meron ding beauty. So, makita natin yan because it reflects the nature of God. So, yung nature ng God, sabi, clearly perceived, no? Maunawaan natin, mararamdaman natin, no? Sa kanyang creation, the things that have been made, no? Parang yung cellphone, no? Yung cellphone dati malaki, tapos yung cellphone is only limited lang sa calling, no? Pero ngayon, if you have a cellphone, so marami na nagagawa yung cellphone, no? Parang laptop na rin yung power ng cellphone. Kasi it has 16 to 32 gigabyte of memory and it has dual core, and hindi lang dual core, octa core, saka deca core na yung mga CPU ng cellphone ngayon. So runs on Android, you can do many things. You can take the pictures, text, and you can put your books. You can do internet, no? So namamangha ka how that cellphone was created, di ba? Ayun. So masasabi mo, oy, talagang matalino ng tao nakakreate ng ganitong bagay, no? So it's a cellphone, it's a small device that you put in your pockets. So ganun din pagka tiningnan natin yung universe na create ng Panginoon, no, mamamangha ka sa design. Mamamangha ka sa beauty. Mamamangha ka sa order of the universe. So verse 21, although they knew God, they did not honor him as God or give thanks to him, no? Instead of acknowledging God and thanking God and worshiping God, men tried to forget about God and to remove God from their conscience or from their reasoning. Yan. So they become foolish in their thinking and their foolish hearts were darkened. Yan. So sometimes it becomes difficult to find meaning and purpose in life without God because you become futile in your thinking and your foolish heart is darkened. So the next element would be ethics and morals. So the discipline dealing with what is good and bad and with moral duty and obligation. No? So yun yung ethics, no? Knowing what is good or bad or good and evil, right and wrong. So it's not only knowing it, but you have a moral duty and obligation. Ibig sabihin, you have to do it. You ought to do it. Yan. Yan yung term doon, no? So knowing what is good or bad and doing what is good is our duty and obligation. So it's a theory of or system of moral values. So principles of conduct governing an individual or group, no? So yun yung prinsipyo na pinag-agrihan ng inyong group o ng inyong community o ng culture o ng iyong nation, no? So yun yung kumbaga acceptable behavior, yung proper behavior or proper conduct. So morals often describe one's particular values concerning what is right and what is wrong. Yan. So God created this universe, physical universe, with order. So it is also a moral universe. So hindi lang physical laws, meron ding moral laws na create ang Panginoon. So between good and evil. So when you assert that there is such a thing as evil, you must assume that there is such a thing as good, no? So nare-recognize naman ng tao what is good or evil across cultures, di ba? So nare-recognize ng tao what is virtue, di ba? Yung mabuting asal, mabuting behavior, mabuting gawa. Merong tayong idea ng ganong mga bagay. So if there is such a thing as good, then there must be a moral law. Dapat merong standard to define what is good and what is evil. What is right and what is wrong. So how can you determine what is right and what is wrong? What is good and what is evil? So there must be a law. No? May batas. Yan. Para malaman mo kung tama o mali yung ginagawa mo. At kung merong batas, dapat meron ding gumawa ng batas. So you must posit a moral lawgiver, the source of the moral law. Yan. And the source of this moral law is beyond man. So hindi yung tao ang gumawa, kundi ang Diyos. So Christian ethics holds that morality is objective and revealed by God. Yan. So ni-reveal ng Panginoon yung moral law sa puso ng bawat isa sa atin. Moral laws are real just like the physical law of gravity. They are true whether or not one believes them or practices them. No? So it's a true thing, no? It exists. Paniwalaan mo o hindi, meron nun. Ayan. At nararapat na i-practice yun. So the ultimate source of ethics is God who created the universe with moral order. So itong moral order, this moral law, flows from the character of God, no? It is determined by His character. So His purpose and His will. So makita natin, no? How do you describe God? So we describe God as holy, 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 no? Yun yung mababasa natin sa Bible lagi. That God is holy. Yan. And the angels would praise Him with holy, holy, holy. Yan. So, it is determined by His character, purpose, and will. And graciously reveals to humans the reality of that order. So, pinapaalam ng Diyos sa atin what is that moral order and how to live according to that reality. No? Yan. So, people may accept it or people may reject it. Katulad ng nabasa natin sa Romans chapter 1. No? Verse 19 to 21, no? God has revealed it to man, and man may accept it or reject it. So the ultimate source of ethics is God who created the universe with moral order. So moral laws apply to all. So it applies to all men at all times. So morality is what we should do. So yun yung moral duty natin, yun yung obligation natin. It is what God requires of us. So walang exemption, no matter what the situation or status. Maging ang ating Panginoong Jesucristo, nang narito siya sa lupa, sinunod niya yung kautusan, kalooban ng Diyos. Ayan. So sabi, nutrition is a good analogy here, no? Kung yung human body requires nutrition para mabuhay, ganun din, kailangan natin ng moral framework para mag-survive, no? Kailangan natin ng moral law para tayo ay mag-survive, para hindi maging magulo, di ba? Hindi maging magulo yung relationship, no? Hindi magkakagulo sa mga ari-arian, hindi magkakagulo sa mga, sa marriage, sa family, no? Kailangan merong moral framework, merong moral law na ating susundin. So we are all born with a moral conscience that tells us right from wrong, no? So meron tayong conscience, no, na determine natin kung ano ba yung tama at mali. Although at times when we are living in sin, so na-affect yung ating conscience, no? Hindi natin na-recognize na mali na yung ginagawa natin until somebody tells us that we are in the wrong. Yan. Na nagkakamali na pala tayo. No? Kasi focus tayo sa ginagawa natin, hindi natin nakikita kung tama o mali na yung ginagawa natin. But salamat sa Panginoon dahil merong mga tao na nagpapaalala sa atin para tayo ay hindi mamali. Hallelujah. So, sources of ethical knowledge. So, ano ba yung magiging source ng ating mga moral laws, no? So, Christians affirm that the Bible is the primary source of knowledge for ethics, no? To know what is good and what is evil, there is that moral law na binigay ng ating lawgiver, ng ating Panginoon. Ayan. And we learn that from the Bible, no? Sa kanyang revelation, sa Word of God. But there are also other secondary sources ng ethics, no? Such as reason, tradition, and experience, no? Ayan. So, kumbaga, yung mga, ano ba yung acceptable behavior ng culture o ng society, no? Ano ba yung natutunan natin by experience, no? Para na malaman natin, ma-evaluate natin isang bagay na tama o mali. So we fall back on our experience. Yan. On our memories. Or we fall back to our tradition, no? Yung mga acceptable na behavior ng ating community. or we fall back to our reasoning, no? So inaaral natin yung pros and cons ng mga bagay na gagawin natin. So other sources have validity, no? But must be tested by and subordinated to scripture as the primary source. So lahat ng bagay tinetest natin using what we know or what has been revealed to us by the scripture, no? Yan. Katulad sa marriage, di ba? Marriage and divorce, yan. So itetest natin yan with scripture. Yan. So ano ba yung concept ng marriage? Man and woman or ano? Man and woman, no? Tinetest sa scripture. Yung divorce, kung kalooban ba ng Diyos yan na may divorce or not? So we test it by scripture. Yan. Kahit na inaalaw siya sa ibang bansa, dito sa bansa natin ay hindi siya inalaw, because we test it by the scripture, by our yung common faith ng society. So it would be naive to ignore or deny other sources, for they are inescapable and will influence or determine moral judgments. So itong mga ibang secondary sources ng ethics would influence or determine moral judgments. So you have to test it, yung secondary sources ng ethics, no? Secondary sources ng mga morals. Because later on it will influence a person whether he acknowledges it or not. Spiritual discernment. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit who is from God, that we might understand the things freely given us by God. Yan. So mahalaga ito, kasi it's true that we have the scriptures, but how we understand the scriptures and how we apply the scriptures, it is taught to us by the spirit of God. And this spirit of God we receive when we receive our Lord Jesus Christ. So we have a better understanding of the scriptures because we have the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, who teaches us that we might understand the scriptures. So it's not taught by human wisdom, but taught by the Spirit, no? Interpreting spiritual truths to those who are spiritual. So we are able to understand this. So we are able to understand the scriptures because we are being taught by the Spirit of God. But the natural person, the natural man, does not accept the things of the Spirit of God. They are folly to him. He is not able to understand them because they are spiritually discerned. Yan, no? So yung tao na who rejected God would find it hard to understand the things of God because it is spiritually discerned. Okay? Ayan. So, purihin ng Diyos, we are able to define, understand, discern what is good and what is evil because the Spirit of God teaches us. No? We receive this wisdom from the Spirit of God. So there are things that human logic is able to reach. So may mga bagay na yung reasoning natin ay pwede makaunawa at pwedeng maabot yung mga bagay na kumbaga yung knowledge, no? Pero may mga bagay na it is beyond our reasoning, beyond our thoughts, beyond our logic, beyond our thinking. And those things are revealed to us by the Spirit of God. Yan. Hallelujah. So, right now, we do not find creation to be as it was when God brought it into being. Kasi nung Genesis chapter 1 and 2, God created the universe and it was good. No, yun yung statement ng Panginoon. It is good. But human sin and rebellion against God has infected the entire creation and drawn it away from obedience to its master. Yan. So when sin entered, we read in Genesis chapter 3, when it entered, there is rebellion against God and has infected the entire creation. The thoughts of man, sabi rin sa Genesis, were evil continually. Yan. We are drawn away from our obedience to God. So, Christian worldview sees the nature of the disharmony and corruption in the world, no? Differently to non-Christian worldview. So, yung problema na nakikita natin sa sanlibutan, it is not because of our genes, no? It's not because of our DNA. Yung problema na nakikita natin sa sanlibutan, it's not because of our social condition. It's not because of economics, no? Kaya yung ibang tao, ang solusyon nila ay economics. Yan. Socialism. Yung problema natin is not caused by evolutionary process or moral weakness. No? Yan. The source of our problems in human life can be traced back to alienation from God. An alienation which came about because of rebellion against God, a desire to make our own decisions as to what constitutes right and wrong, that is, sin. Ayan. Yun ang problema natin sa sanlibutang ito. Kasalanan, sin. So we have that desire to make our own decisions independent of God. No? Gusto natin autonomous. No? Ayaw natin na pasakop sa Diyos. No? We want to be the king in our own right. We want to be the God in our own right. Okay, so for the last slide, we have worldviews in conflict, no? So, maraming type ng worldviews, pero ang nilagay ko yung dalawang worldview, no? Christian theism, which is the biblical worldview, and naturalism, which is the atheist worldview. It is the humanist, secular humanism worldview, itong naturalism. So, ano to? Naturalism, atheism, and secular humanism as opposed to Christian theism or the biblical worldview. So, yung first item is reality or metaphysics. Yun yung, kumbaga, technical term. So, God exists and God is the creator. And he has a creation. And God is a personal and moral being. No? And God upholds creation. And God declares that creation is very good. And that the creation is an open system. Meaning to say, God can do miracles. God can do special revelation. Pwede mangusap ang Diyos sa pamagitan ng kanyang mga propeta. Pwede mangusap ang Diyos sa pamagitan ng kanyang mga propeta, sa kanyang salita, which is the Bible. Ayan. Ang Diyos pwede mag-intervene. Pwede niyang sagutin ang mga prayers. It's an open system. God can do miracles. Ayan. Yan ang ibig sabihin ng open system. No? Ayan. So, God can exercise His dominion, His power, His sovereignty overall creation. Yan. So, we see from a naturalist or an atheist worldview, universe is self-existent. Ibig sabihin, the universe is eternal. There is no God, and God is an illusion or a superstition. No? Projection lang siya, no? Superstitious projection. No? And that matter and energy, yun lang yung physical universe, matter and energy. And it is a closed system, no? Wala nang iba pang, walang divine intervention. Yan. And you are, sabi dito, determinism, you are programmed to do what you are doing, you know? Because nature has designed it to be that way. Yan. So yun yung concept ng reality. Christian theism, the biblical worldview versus naturalism. Now when it comes to, when it comes to knowledge, truth exists in God. How do you determine what is true and what is false? How do you determine what is right and what is wrong? So truth exists in God. It is revealed in creation and revealed in scripture. No? And it is also revealed in the sciences. Yan. So later on, we will discuss the two types of people who do science. In the next lesson. So that's the view of Christian theist and the naturalist, the atheist. Man is the measure of all things, no? So lahat ng bagay, you arrive at the truth by use of reason and experience. So what's the problem with the naturalist point of view? Sin has affected our reasoning. Sin has affected our thoughts. Sin has affected our desires. Yan. Kaya sabi, our thoughts become futile and our hearts are darkened. Okay. And next thing is ethics is determined by God, disclosed in His revelation. So there's a natural revelation in His creation, and there's a special revelation in the Word of God and in the use of God of His prophets, and it is discovered by man. No? It is revealed to us by God, and we discover these things. So, in naturalism, what is right and what is wrong is determined by man. So, the problem with this is that every man has his own standard, has his own moral law. No, it becomes, truth becomes relative. Truth is not absolute or is not objective. So it is disclosed by reason and experience. So reason and experience. It is autonomous, meaning to say, sa akin lang to. No? Ito yung view ko, autonomy. No? I am independent. No? It's situational. No? Depende sa situation. So that's how a naturalist would view ethics. Okay? Okay, so next we have a nature of human beings. We are created in the image of God, but from an atheist point of view, we are derived from lower, simpler life forms, no? So next is our human predicament, sin, rebellion against God leading to separation from self and others. What is man's problem, no? From a Christian point of view, it's sin. But from a naturalist point of view, man's problem is the result of his superstition, is the result of his environment. Man's problem is because of economics, the unequal distribution of wealth. Yan. Man's problem is an unconscious mind. No? He's not conscious of what is happening. Yan. Yes, different mindset. Yan. So that's man's problem according to a naturalist. And the solution to human predicament, ano solution natin sa problema natin sa sanlibutan from a Christian point of view? Salvation in Jesus Christ. Reconciled back to God. Yan. Reconciled to your own self, to others, and to the world. But from a naturalist or an atheist point of view, it is science, reason, technology, education. Yan. And because man's problem is unequal distribution of wealth, there must be a robust economy. Yan. Or a genome project, meaning it's in your DNA, it's in your genes. Or maybe it's a psychoanalyst therapy. Yan. So, yan po yung... That's why its worldview, meron siyang claim. Each worldview has its own truth claim. And they are not in agreement. No, they are not in agreement. They are in conflict with each other. No, So the biblical worldview is in conflict from a naturalist and secular humanist worldview. So umpisa pa lang, the existence of God is already a conflict between these two worldviews. Yan. So purihin ng Panginoon, salamat sa kanyang kabutihan. Tayo po ay manalangin and we will continue with our next lesson on the next Wednesday. So tayo po'y manalangin. Salamat po dakilang Diyos sa iyong kabutihan, sa inyong pong pagtuturo sa bawat isa po sa amin. Patuloy na turuan mo kami, Panginoon, sa iyong salita. At patuloy na maunawaan namin ang biblical worldview, na malaman namin ang iyong kalooban at ito'y aming maisagawa, aming magampanan sa tulong na rin at biyaya ng iyong banal na Espiritu. Kaya't salamat po, Ama, sa lahat ng ito. Patuloy na dalangin namin ang iyong pag-iingat, pagbabasbas sa bawat isa sa amin, kagalingan sa lahat ng aming mga karamdaman, at pagsaway sa lahat ng karamdaman na ninanais ng kaaway na ibigay sa tahanan ng bawat isa sa amin. Salamat po, Ama, sa iyong pag-iingat, sa iyong proteksyon. Salamat, Ama, sa iyong mga himala sa aming mga buhay. Sa pangalan mo po na aming Panginoon Jesucristo, sa inyo po, O Diyos, lahat ng kapurihan, kapasalamatan. Amen. Praise God. Magandang gabi muli sa Panginoon at sa bawat isa. Hallelujah.